Back to game number two in a special three series between the Ghost Boys and the Ninjas in Pajamas. My name is Dragon Drop. I'm joined by Llama Down Under. Welcome back.
Hey, and yeah, I feel like Golden Boys, immediately the IO ban out. I am not sure on the docs here. I would have just banned out the Tiny as well, honestly, if I were them. It feels like just getting a little bit outplayed there in that last game. And making sure that not having Ninjas in Pajamas have such comfortable heroes could work. But yeah, it's going to be instead the Shadow Fiend Tusk.
Yeah, Shadow Fiend Tusk is strong as it gets once again. I mean, why change a running system, right? The one with the last game, Limp, very good in Shadow Fiend. Yone Sifon, very good in Tusk. So it's really hard to actually ban out all the comfortable heroes for Ninjas in Pajamas in the first phase. So kind of have to pick your poison there. They ban out the Wisp in hopes, once again, that that's enough to actually get away from the Tiny as well, which normally it is the case. But, well, not in the last game. We'll see if Ninjas in Pajamas want to go for a similar kind of lineup or whether they won't have something else up their sleeves as they're up against the Queen of Pain and an Ancient Apparition now. And Golden Boys even banning out the Keep of the Light again. They really don't want to play up against this. And yeah, Ninjas in Pajamas ban out the Broodmother, ban out the Nightstalker Doom. So pretty 6.85 bans from them and just heroes that are really uncomfortable playing against here. 10 seconds yeah, remaining. Golden Boys though, they need, as you said, they need something else. They need some kind of different plan to not go necessarily into the late game up against the Ninjas, because that's where they're really not favored at all, I feel like.
Yeah, I mean, they can try for an earlier push lineup. They could also try for... I think that really what happened in that last game was just a couple superior pickoffs from NiP and the itemization. Not having BKBs on Golden Boys really made them suffer. So Ninja's going to bring in that Ember Spirit, looking like it's probably a safe lane Ember, because of course Ember versus Co-op mid is terrible and they already have the SF. But Golden Boys, I mean, they have a bunch more picks. They have more supports, more heroes. They can try to make sure they have the lockdown for Ember. Unlike last game, it really felt like NiP barely had the lockdown until they got items up.
So. Yeah. They do have the Queen of Pain, which can build an Orchid, so that's one of the better ways to deal with an Ember and kind of forcing him to go into a Lincoln Sphere or Mantis style sooner rather than later. So that's one way to deal with him, Spellbreaker. Huh. I like that as well. Just that's one way also to kind of mitigate the Ember Spirit's impact in the game. Just trying to keep him down early, as early as he can. Spellbreaker, with only one or two levels, he can start charging across the map. With a little bit of help, he can bring down the Ember Spirit out of that offlane, which it's kind of hard to do, especially with a Tusk who can go for any sort of go for early TP rotations, kind of put a stop to these kind of plans. And once Ember Spirit gets a couple of levels, that can really turn around on you quick as well, just with the strength of the Flame Guard, not just as a source of protection, but also a source of damage here up against anyone else. And then the Bane too. Interesting pick here for NiP, one that they run rather often as well though, so it's once again, so
it's
many comfort heroes on this team. Yeah. Yeah, that's
it's
one
basically,
thing.
Basically, we need a lot more lockdown. It's going to help against the Quap. It's going to help against Spirit Breaker charging into people. You can Nightmare him up. You can just Fiend Grip him once the Bane is high enough level. And you can also, maybe, depending on how they want to, you can run a Tusk Bane dual lane, which just brings a lot of hell to the safe lane farmer if you go the Enfeeble build. So it's a nice amount of lockdown, and it's a good way to deal with the Quap without having to pick up something like a Lion, which they still have room for on NiP.
Yep. Lion wouldn't hate that. Always is really solid support. A lot of lockdown, a lot of burst damage as well from his ultimate if you need it. But Golden Boys, they pick up the Slaughter, which is something that I... actually, with the Spirit Breaker pickup, kind of makes me wonder where they want to put him. If they want to put him in the one position, it kind of leaves them pretty much blank when it comes to late game potential, when it comes to late game carry potential. So that would put them under a lot of pressure to execute early and then the mid game. But then again, with the Slaughter and the Queen of Pain, that's something that you can do. And with that amplified damage up against an Ember Spirit, that drastically reduces the time that you need to have him locked down until it can actually kill him. So it's one possible solution, but it's a different kind of timing window than you can actually want to go for up against an Ember Spirit. If you go late against Ember or Shadow Fiend, it gets really hard pretty much no matter what lineup you have.
Yeah, it definitely feels like Ember Spirit, or not feels like, it is the case that Ember Spirit can't deal with physical damage. That's what he has trouble with. And so it's nice to pick up the Slaughter there. And the Spirit Breaker has another benefit on the Ember. It just constantly reveals where he is. So even if he like remnants away and is crazy, it's a bit easier than if you're up against the Ember just blind. So both the amp damage and the Spirit Breaker will help out. But NiP now, I really think that they could go something like the Shadow Shaman or Lion if they wanted. I assume this is an offlane Tusk and not a support Tusk.
Yeah, it could be
So.
either, honestly, because with the Bane would be an easy setup for the Tusk to make it easier to get the eye shots in the right position to block someone off. I mean, wouldn't put it past him, but then again, Jonathan Fan, he's so strong in that offlane Tusk that it's really, really hard to imagine that being that someone else be playing him. They're probably looking for another support now. It's Rana comes to mind if you want to go old school here, Rana Bane combo.
Yeah, it's certainly got a lot of lockdown potential, but I always worry with the Marana. She's very dependent on actually hitting those arrows. And so if you begin it and you don't, if you go, maybe 6 minutes, you haven't landed one, you're pretty much useless for the rest of the game.
Yeah, but then again,
So.
Bane can help you with that, just with the easy setup for with a nightmare. But it's I agree, it's not really the easiest combo to actually to actually do enough with. I think that's the way to put it. You need to have these skills, you need to have momentum that way, because defensively, it's only so much you can do with that. But yeah, we'll see. Probably not going to be that. Just putting it out there.
Also for Golden Boys, do you think this is a, well, yeah, they're looking for a hard carry. It's always something where you can pick up the Spectre when there's an AA. It's just a nice global present, especially with the Spirit Breaker as well. It's going to be Clockwork, so that is a support
Dire
Tusk.
team
And
pick.
I think
Oh, it is,
it's,
okay.
while the Spectre's like kind of squishy, and the Clockwork can certainly be presence there. I think you have a lot of easy ways to farm if you go the Spectre just because an AA blast hits, maybe someone is charged on, and it works out really well for you.
I'm not even with that though, I'm not really sure if the Spectre really hits the timing window that Golden Boys is probably looking for here with the with what they already
10 seconds
have.
remaining.
If Spectre gets the slightest bit shut down, make no mistake,
Five
Ninjas in
seconds
Pajamas have the potential to
remaining.
do that between the Clockwork, between the Tusk, Mistbird even coming for rotations, Bane locking and
Reserve
Spectre
time.
down. It's so easy to get pickoffs on that hero with this lineup that it's really, really risky, I feel, for Golden Boys to go that kind of route. I'm actually looking for.
They can also go with the Slark. The Slark would
Yeah.
work well. It's good against Clockwork. It does have the same issues that Bane's Fiend Grip is the killer for Slark. And that's why I like the Spectre a little bit more. Just it's hard to find the right Spectre in the Haunt. Shadow Fiend and Spirit Ember Spirit. Yeah, Ember Spirit, once he has the Battle Fury, gets a bit of a buff there, but she isn't the easiest to lock down in those team fights. She is squishy, which is her problem. And Slark will have a better time against the Clock in lane, I think.
Not even sure they're looking for another core here. I mean, they might as well go for something like an aggressive trial in here between the ancient apparition, the Slaughter plus one with a little bit of initial control, something like a Rubick or something along those lines, to set up for the Slaughter crush, to set up for a bunch of chilling touch right clicks, and have the Spirit Breaker just in the safe lane, farming up Queen of Pain mid. Same time, you can go many different routes that involve a Spirit Breaker in core position or duo or offlane, something along those lines. And yeah, Earthshaker fits that bill. He can
So,
also roam around the map, give some space for the Queen of Pain, kind of make Shadow Fiend's life a little bit harder if there's not enough ward coverage.
yeah, it's the safe lane farming Slaughter though, and I think offlane Earthshaker. So, I think that it's an interesting lineup. I'm really worried for Golden Boys. They won't have, yes, you have the amp damage, but Slaughter as a right click carry is always hard to build. To optimize that, so I'm not sure how well this will go for
Prepare
them.
for battle. Yeah, and with that, if you're just tuning in, welcome. My name's Dragon Drop. I'm joined by Llama Down Under here for game number two, the Dota 2 Champions League matchup between NiP and the Golden Boys. Remember, this is an upper bracket match. The loser of this will drop down, but they're not out of it just yet. But the winner of this, especially if it's NiP in this match, they will punch their ticket to the main event. So, yeah. Don't really want to run through our lineups already, since it looks like we might see a level 1 fight. Golden Boys are smoked up. They do have an Earthshaker, and they're running straight into NiP. If they can get a good Fissure block, that might spell doom for Era here. Nice little block off with the charge coming in as well. Gets the steam chains off. And Hanskin with perfectly placed ice shards will put a stop to that. So very good reactions on their part, and that'll probably put an end to the aggression. So let's take a quick look at the lineups here. We've got Golden Boys with Madara on that one position slot, like Kaiser on the mid Queen of Pain. We've got maybe next time playing that Earthshaker. Skylark on that Spirit Breaker, and that only leaves Skanks playing that Ancient Apparition here in the support position.
Yeah, and on NIP, we're going to have Jonasson Fan on the Clockwork, Bane being played by Seal Kid, Ember played by Era, SF played by Limp, and finally that Tusk being played up by Hanskin. And it'll be interesting to see exactly where they focus their efforts. The mid lane, Queen of Pain will win until level 5, and then there'll be stacks, hopefully this to game, for the SF.
Yeah.
So he'll catch up quickly. But I worry it doesn't feel like NIP has good kill potential on that Queen of Pain until the Bane comes a bit higher leveled.
Yeah, that's kind of the problem that you have if you have a Bane. I mean, he can set up, but what does he reset up? A couple of level 1 raises, or level 2 raises later on? Not really a whole lot. What he can do, and Seal Kid's keeping his options open, is to skill and feeble and putting down on Kaiser. But even then, he has a Chilling Touch extra buff up to help him with these first couple of last hits, which is nice.
Interesting.
To see, actually.
I haven't seen that one before. I think what's getting really popular right now is putting 2 mid so that you can make sure that your mid gets the better start than your opponent's. But
yep.
Queen of Pain doesn't super need that against a Shadow Fiend. Maybe they're just worried about the skill differential, but she already out damages him by a huge amount just naturally. And unless the Bane came mid with like Enfeeble, I think she should. The Queen of Pain should win the lane.
Yeah, for sure. And Seal Kid, yeah, not actually going for that. He's still sticking around, looking for the first stack already, it looks like, here on his medium camp. But yeah, it's as you said, Queen of Pain should win this matchup early on, but it's still nice to see. But Limp, he knows what's happening. He knows that he's disadvantaged here, so he actually went for the raises level 1. Got a couple of last hits, and now he has his level 2 to start picking up these souls.
Yeah,
so
he went the first bottle rush.
Eventually he will catch up. Eventually he will have these stacks to fall back on. So it's kind of a wash here. The one thing that can kind of make it a little bit different is we see an Earthshaker roaming around, getting a good Fissure block off, and a Queen of Pain, just able
or
to
even
burst
Spirit Breaker. So.
Or Spirit Breaker, yeah. Or both of them. Hell, why not?
Yes. Why you can just send all 5 mid. No, it's actually as much as we're joking now. It's actually really a smart thing to do. SF is one of those snowball heroes. If you pick him off, you know, at the 5 minutes, at the 10 minutes, with those good timings, preferably either before he takes the stacks or basically as he's going for them, because that's another play you can make. Golden Boys can try to smoke into NIP's jungle to take those stacks. You really shut down his farm. SF can't play from behind, but he can catch up fast.
Yep. No, you don't. There's plenty of ways to deal with the Shadow Fiend. It's picking him off a couple of times, but then, as you said, you have to pace it really well so that he doesn't really get a chance to catch up. Just regularly pick him off. Ward his jungle.
Ooh. Up top, we've got the cogs onto. Oh gosh, they're just gonna kill off Golden Boys. This should be the first blood. One more auto attack. Bane gets it. Bane got really unlucky, got stuck in the cogs with Battery Assault. Both of those only level 1, but Battery Assault does so much damage if you're the only one taking them. And even at level 1, I know at max level it's like 1,000 damage, but at level 1, more than enough to kill off that AA.
Absolutely. Caught himself in a bit of a tough spot there. I mean, I saw him lurking around this area here, just getting a Chilling Touch right clicks up on the clockwork. But yeah, then getting caught in cogs with Seal Kid there as well. Of course, setting that up with the Nightmare, I presume. Not really the best that they could have hoped for here, giving up first blood already. But it's kind of this threat that you run as an Ancient Apparition, not really having the best laning presence all alone like that.
Yeah, you're
well,
not mid, someone like
hang
a
on, Earthshaker. Oh, they're gonna go for Limp. He actually dropped very low to the harassment from Kaiser. Tried to rely on his haste to get him out of trouble, but maybe next time with a tiny rotation there, they find that kill and yep. Overall, it's probably still in favor of Golden Boys then, considering.
Yeah, I think that it's still very even, and as we've talked about, as long as, and they've already placed wards to check out these stack rotations. They're going on SF again? Yeah, they're charging him. So there's going to be the Shadow Strike Co-op, probably just trying to put some more harassment on him. He is going to be a fissure in a second. He's going to try to go for that hidey hole, and now realizing Skylock that he cannot be there. Seal Kid's coming as well. Nice fissure just to help Skylock escape, and that's nice. Oh, but here comes Handskin. There's perfect ice shields blocking them off. They should have enough damage to work on Handskin, but both are probably going to lose their lives. One raise, a nice stun, but now Earthshaker's going to go down. Can the Spirit Breaker get away? And up top, it looks like AA did manage to kill off the Clockwork with the help, of course, of Slaughter. So, all over the map. Lots of people going down.
It's like not really easy for the camera person to just try and catch those. If you look at one kill, then it doesn't happen, or it happens later than you expected, and action happens. But yeah, it's interesting to see that. But yeah, looks like they listen to you, right? Putting on pressure on Limp wherever they can. It was probably a wise decision to fall back there the moment they saw the Bane coming up.
Yeah, I mean, it's something where you just have to keep going on the SF. You have to. Oh, we've got. Helmskin taking. He gets bashed. He gets a little bit of the poison. So. But I think that the Ember Spirit, you have a lot more time with him just because his early farming isn't. He doesn't have any tool, a mechanism like Razor. It looks like Clockwork getting dived super deep, but he's going to walk it off and has TP rotation. So. Yeah. And it's going to be just. If you can keep this raise the SF down, he doesn't form back up as fast maybe as other people. So
yeah, you do need a couple of levels into raises. He has that now though. He has level 5, so probably does he actually have stacks? He has one double stack here. It's not a whole lot.
And they were really aware of it. If he did have stacks, I'm pretty sure that Golden Boys would have gone for the rotation into their opponent's jungle to catch that.
This early ward that you pointed out earlier, I really love this a lot. Yeah. Just keeping tabs on the stack, on the stacks, especially this hard game, which is so much golden experience coming their way, and then setting up for presumably, they're farming it now, so I would assume that they want to try and find a pickoff now. Skylark has a charge, just waiting for him right now. They need some more help though, that's the problem.
Yeah, they might decide since SF and Bane, they know they're there, they might go for pressure somewhere else, because you know this does mean that there are less supports to rotate bottom, but. That is all up to them. And also, I think since it's a double stack, what you really get worried about is because at the 5 minute, you can have quad stacks up, right? And then SF suddenly comes out of the jungle with a Yasha, and you're like, what?
Oh, top lane. Some fun. Just a little bit of harassment.
And they actually cancel the TPs. I don't think that Golden Boys saw that, but again, if Golden Boys saw the cancelled TP, it's always another, we can maybe go for a gank somewhere else on the map, because that means that there won't be rotations, but they are doing their own stacking, it looks like. Do they have it? Yeah, they're gonna start now. Queen of Pain also can take stacks very easily. She doesn't have as easy tool as the Raze, since she just has the Scream of Pain, but it's still not the roughest. And Clockwork might be in a lot of trouble. He's now trying to chase them over. Gets hit by the Slithering Crush and... Never mind. Gonna ult calm down.
Yeah, there's no more mana on Earthshaker or Madara. He only had enough for the one single crush. But one thing I want to point out is, of all the heroes in Dota, we have the three heroes that can manipulate the environment. You have the Earthshaker with the Fissure, you have the Clockwork with the Cogs, and you have the Tusk with the Ice Shards. And one of these crazy kind of situations that that can result from that, we just saw there. We had like the Cogs here in a box, and then the Fissure straight through it, and no one could move, essentially. Golden Boys couldn't get close thanks to the Cogs, and Clockwork also couldn't get out because of the Fissure, so it's pretty funny to see sometimes.
Now, we haven't had any kills in a bit. Things just kind of calming down. It looks like Queen of Pain is topping the net worth chart just because she got that early rotation on the SF. But certainly now that Bane is getting a few levels, if Queen of Pain takes two raises, she could be in a bit of trouble. So if she exchanges any harass with SF, she could be in trouble.
Yep. That Clockwork also, some fun. I mean, he gave up that one kill, but he also got the first blood. And he's already level 6, right? That's the point. That's a really good timing for an offlane. And now Kaiser, he's kind of exposed to that kind of gank right now.
It's really hard. I think that Jonathan Fan, I mean, you have a bit of lockdown with the hookshot, but you have to get very lucky. He was probably hoping that Co-op would maybe misuse her blink. Early levels, it's got a 15-second cooldown, so if she uses it, you can kill her off. That's more than enough time. But unfortunately, she's not falling for that. She's going to jungle. And so this Clockwork, he's looking to use the right when he gets the hook. He's looking to use it, but it's Quaff isn't the mid where you can go for that without the Bane having follow-up lockdown.
Oh, well, all without the Madara, actually. He might be a better target to go for. He does get the Boundary Rune, but now he's trying to run away, but he's in range of the Battery Assault. Kaiser's there. Maybe they can turn this around here after Madara falls, but don't want to here. And there's the hookshot, actually, onto the Earthshake under the tower. There's the Sonic Wave. It's not going to be enough, or is it? With the tower shot, Jonas and Fahn, he should survive. Kaiser as well, but it's two heroes down still in favor of NiP.
Yeah, really well played from the Clockwork there. Jonathan Fan made sure to hookshot onto I think what we talked about, he knew he couldn't actually kill off the Quap, so he went for the Earthshaker, and also he had a lot of support in the area. So a really nice play there, and also all of this, while it goes on, it makes space for the Ember Spirit. While their supports are dying, they can't be doing anything, so Era, he is farming up a Storm, second in the top net worth.
That is not what you want to hear if you're a Golden Boys fan. Especially, also Shadow Fiend. I mean, you said it a minute ago that Quap was topping up the net worth. Not anymore. Olympus is about 600 ahead, 500 ahead. Not all that significant right now, but it's only gonna get worse here, especially if he doesn't get picked off again, if he has more space to farm and flash farm, right? That's kind of his strength. So if he gets a couple of thousand gold ahead, then we will see that crazy and scary Shadow Fiend that just takes over the mid game instead of the Quap, right? That's what, if you Gold Boys, that was the game plan, right? Get the Quap off to a good start. Kaiser is building into the Orchid, which can still be super effective if you can get it off on the Ember Spirit later on.
It's always a good item to go on Quap when you're against an Ember, just because it forces him into one of those defensive items. Yeah. As we talked about last game, he doesn't want to have to build the Manta, he doesn't want to have to build BKB, but Quap having an Orchid, he has to go for one of those, and it's kind of just a wasted slot on Ember. Neither give you huge amounts of damage for their defensive properties. So that'll be why she's going for that Orchid, and then she'll build Aghanims. And hopefully after that, depends on how the game goes, she may be forced into a Shiva's or a Sheep.
Top lane, might see an engagement here. Jonas and Fahn is charged up, but little do they know the Hounds can still get ahead. They're gonna go on Madara and back at the same time. Jonas and Fahn, should be able to burst him off. There we go, especially with Madara joining, he's being nightmared up. But now Olympus there as well. Nice little setup for the Razors, and the Fissure actually leaves Madara to die for sure. Skanks, next one on the list, and Skylark hit maybe next time. Same for Kaiser here, they have to run, they have to scramble here. As Era is joining the fray with the Flame Guard here, just running them down. Same time, Hanskin with the Snowball. Trying to go for Kaiser here, not the easiest kill though. And he gets the Sonic Wave off before the Nightmare can come out. Seal Kit. Oh, wow, Kaiser gets a Blink off just in time. Before the second raise could hit, but they know where he is, they're looking for him.
Yeah, they actually didn't realize how far back he jumped, so they're now pinging over to the other side, but oh, they see her with the rocket. Air may be able to get in with that other remnant. He goes for it, breaks all the trees, and that's very dead, and that's what we talked about, the blink cooldown. It's so long early levels, 15 seconds, you just can't get out.
Yeah, it actually was off cooldown there for quite a while, but didn't choose to use it. It's kind of... Same time, there were like two remnants in that general area, so it's really, really hard to get out at that point without a TP scroll, which was on cooldown, so it's...
Yeah. And maybe next time I'm going to TP out. I think for Golden Boys, they want to try to slow this game down as much as they can, because they can't take the team fights right now, and it's something where they need AA to get levels, they need the Echo Slam, they just really, really need to... slow it down, get some farm onto this lot, or maybe a blink, maybe a four staff. So.
Yep. Well, he's getting that blink now, so one last hit was all he needed there, so that'll mean that he will have that initiation factor now.
It looks, Clockwork gets a kill, Queen of Pain coming in though, and now has the Shadow Strike, has the Enchant Totem off the mark, but the Fissure's not. Spirit Breaker go down elsewhere, but that's gonna be a very dead Clockwork, and up top it looks like Era is just causing a lot of trouble. Now going for a tier 2 push. While they got a kill there for Golden Boys, and it was certainly in their favor because of how far behind they are right now, about 5,000 in net worth, it's not looking good. This Ember... Oh, Eren actually decided not to go the bot, so he's going to have a very early Battle Fury unless they kill him.
Bottom lane, they get the pick off on a Tusk as well. Yeah, that was the reveal of the Blink Dagger, I would assume, here, but that just blinks right on top of him with the Amplified damage. A lot of bursts comes out before Snowball can... And... Same time. Era, these being charged up. Do they have the lockdown? Does he have a remnant up? Doesn't actually look like it in Madara. with a TP blink rotation in, gets that kill. Or secures that kill at least with a crush. Steel Kid. He will find the ward. But he might actually. I don't know if that was the right idea to come up there. They need some sort of counter plan. That's a Clockwork hooking in. Steel Kid will still die, but so will Skylark. It looks like there's the Echo Slam though. That will secure the kill on Limp. Now the Snowball comes. Actually, Limp was saved by Snowball for a second there. Well, the second is not enough here in this game. Is Madara still alive and kicking? Same for Maiden next time. Another Fissure will secure that kill with the damage over time from Skanks. And yeah, Golden Boys, they're turning it up now. NiP coming into fights that they are not really prepared for. That's Lada with the blink. It all started with that bait from Seal Kid that just went terribly, terribly wrong.
Yeah, I think that was a classic case of going in one by one. They really could have done a lot better in their team fighting, and instead going in one by one for NiP just really did not work out for them.
Yeah. This is also where the lockdown really, really shines. I mean, if you look at the Earthshaker, that's where maybe next time he really carried the team. I think there was two Fissures in that fight, plus the Echo Slam, to make sure that the Shadow Fiend's effectiveness, who is the highest farmer still
going on to Error again. There's the Blink Full. If they have the Slithering Curse, they need a bit more, I think, but no, they might just have it. They need a Bash with the Fissure, they get it. So
just talking about him once again, the Fissure comes out just at the right time. Oh, there's Oakshot throwing onto Madara. He does have a crush available, but Yonasafan catches him in with the Cox. He's trying to get the hell out. There's the Ice Shards actually blocking Seal Kid, but not enough. Not far away enough to block the Fiend's Grip. They will pick off the Slaughter.
So it's a one for one, but I think that the Slaughter was a less... Yeah, it should be a little bit in favor of Golden Boys just because of Era's net worth. So still good for Golden Boys. Unfortunate they lost their Slaughter. Maybe they can do something while knowing Fiend's Grip is down, though, and Hookshot. So, and also this Clockwork, he seemed to be having a great game. We talked about it, but now being forced into two braces, finally going to work on his four stuff. But feeling like that good start kind of gone into braces instead of what we're more used to, which would be something like the Ags or the
gonna go again this time on the Earthshaker. Maybe next time all alone, but a teleport reaction come in. Can he get a Fissure out? Yes, he can. But yeah, he's still alive. But he will finally fall here. The Fissure actually blocking his teammates to try and get any counter kills, but they will still find Hanskin on the back of these blinks. Ancient Apparition actually gets it, so Skanks with the snipe coming out, making it another one-for-one trade.
But Era picks off AA on the top lane, just using that Searing Chains combo. And in that teamfight, the Earthshaker stayed alive so long because of a nice Enchant Totem proc, which was fantastic. But I think that partly Era's NiP, and Era has been in the jungle of Golden Boys, but also the AA blast, I think, flew over a ward, gave him a bit more of an idea that it was along this vector, and he just found the AA.
Yep.
So, a little bit unfortunate there.
It's something that you have to watch. I mean, you can say what you want about Madara's Ember Spirit in the last game and about his item choices in the later parts, but for the longest time, he's been doing a really, really good job, and he's been the cause of so much problems for NiP in that last game. And Era, he's on a path to do the exact same thing back to Golden Boys now. He's finding these kills. I'm sure he's being picked off, but that's only because the chain stun was immaculate from Golden Boys so far, and that might not always be the case, and that might not always be enough with the farm that's coming out on this Ember now. Smoke out Madara, leading the charge with the sprint. They're looking for him.
Yeah, they'll see what they can find. They know exactly where he is based on this ward, but whether he'll stay around enough, and he feels like something's up as well, not seeing anybody on the board, this Clockwork Rocket only scouting one, makes him a bit wary, and NiP, the Golden Boy is not looking like this smoke is going to latch. And at the same time, Limp and Bane has, Seal Kid has a smoke of his own, so maybe going to go for one of them and see what they can do. I think at this point, both teams should be keeping an eye on the Roshan, of course, because SF has that that Presence of the Dark Lord, which reduces armor, and then of course amp damage. You can take down Roshan really easily.
Yep. Same time, if you're NiP, you can also just look for a fight around Roshan. I mean, if you look at Limp, he's working on his BKB. He's almost has it, actually. Will get much, much closer after this Ancient Stack. He already has the Mechanism. Clockwork already got the 4-star just now, so they're starting to get their items up. They can start feeling more comfortable taking these fights once again.
Yeah, it's always hard though for a limp. Of course, if he gets hit by the A blast, that mech is going to do nothing, although maybe it'll help out a teammate who isn't hit by it.
Top lane,
So I don't
Oakshot will
know.
actually miss. You know, some fun. He's still force-stuffing forward, but little does he know that there's support here. The charge will be ineffective. Maybe next time we'll still fall, but. Okay, Golden Boys, they don't elect to try and help out instead. They will sacrifice Skylark as well. The Ice Blast will hit, but he doesn't get his ultimate off, and that'll be that.
Yeah, I think if he could have gotten the Nether Strike off there, maybe something he could do. I think it's still a level. Yeah, it's AA's level 8, so it's a level 1 AA blast. Not enough to make anyone shatter, even with the Nether Strike, so a bit unfortunate. And you can see they keep scouting Roshan with the rocket. Both teams very aware of how easy it is for them to do it, for the other to do it. Quap has finished up her Orchid as well, so we'll see whether Era is going to respond to that after his Battle Fury is done.
Yeah, kind of has to, right? I mean, just build the Lincolns, which is not unheard of on the Whisper. Gives you that split second, even if you have a way to proc the Lincolns and then get the Orchid on. You still have that split second of reaction time that you need as an Embers to still jump to a Remnant to ensure they can do that split push, that you can farm around the map and feel safe doing it. But at this point, he doesn't have it. And that is quite dangerous, because if they can keep the Ember Spirit down, that keeps the timing window open for Golden Boys. And
yeah,
make
I
no
think part of
mistake, the time is running out, actually.
Yeah. It's something where it's very hard with the Slaughter and the Queen of Pain. I mean, how exactly do you itemize to go late? And Slaughter's actually, after getting his blink, going back for a Midas, realizing that this game may go a little bit longer than they want, and he won't be able to keep up with the farm, although there is finally that smoke gank that we'd seen on the Bane. It is rotating up, and they might be able to find Queen of Pain here. They do have the Fiend's Grip, but they have to see her first. Can they do it? She blinks over to the side. Do they have any sort of catch? Here comes Era. He does manage to get off the Searing Chains, but now he's silenced up. Doesn't matter. They actually stopped the Fiend's Grip, and now going in for more people in the snowball. There's going to be an AA blast, so it's going to hit all three of them. An Echo Slam. It should mean that Hanskin shatters. He needs just a tiny bit more of damage, but Mandra goes down, and Hanskin might be just all right because he's so tanky. Seemed like
Man.
With that AA blast they could do something, but just not enough damage output.
Yeah, level 1's kind of underwhelming. You need the follow-up, and it was technically there with the Echo Slam, but that was about all. Queen of Pain being called out like that, forced to come back to base. I mean, sure, Kaiser was staying alive, which is pretty much what Golden Boys were looking for. In first place here is the main priority, but still, using your big ultimates like that, especially the Echo Slam, and not finding a kill, even losing your Slaughter. And now Kaiser, he's running into Era. Has to walk away straight off the bat, losing a lot of time down in the bottom lane. Might even be able to catch him out. You know, Sylvan does not have the hookshot quite yet, though.
Yeah, and Era's got up that Battle Fury very early, all things considered. As you said, Limp has his BKB. Now, of course, the BKB you can still shatter if you take too much damage, but it does stop the ticks of ice of Frostbite, which is...
Charge will be interrupted here, kid. Now the one being silenced up as Kaiser tries to dish out some damage, but not Skylark. He's left all alone. Era, he has double damage soon, and yeah, that's an easy pickup, even with the Fissure coming out. That was, yeah, they're trying to use the Spirit Breaker, but they can't quite find the openings, and that's one of the problems that I see for Golden Boys. Spirit Breaker is a hero that you need to get something off of. You need to be able to put on the pressure. You need to be able to find kills. And you need to not
Slaughter's
die, Madara.
Also gonna go down. Madara's going down. Trying to, maybe with amp damage, he needs lucky bashes. Can he get a seal kit? He's got one. If he gets, with the Sleight of Fist. I was going to say, if he can just stay off, cut off from the rest of them with those cogs. But of course, Era gets lots of damage out with still having the end of that DD. And there was no escape.
That was a questionable decision for me, for Madara to still be there after what happened there, right? I mean, Spirit Breaker just got picked off. What do you expect to happen down there past the river?
Yeah, not the best opportunity.
Gonna go again though, Era charged up. Skylark gets the ultimate off. Kaiser's here with the Orchid, and that should be a kill now. No support there, especially with the Fissure. Finally, they find what they're looking for, but at the same time, what happens on the other side of the map? Limp, he's still farming. He has his BKB and a Yasha now on the way on the courier.
Yeah, so Limp probably, he may potentially go Manta just so he doesn't have to pop BKB to get unsilenced, but as we talked about before, Shadowfiend not always as worried about being silenced up. Always good to get rid of the silence and not have to worry about the extra damage and so on, but it's not your biggest fear. So it could just be a Sanjin Yasha for more tank, more withstanding the AA blast.
And so, yeah, speaking of AA blasts, look at Skanks. He's actually looks like he's going for Glimmer Cape. Not really doing a good pace on that, obviously, since he is an ancient apparition. Once again, the lack of the Midas. Do you think the Glimmer
Yeah.
Cape is that valuable in this game?
No, it's what we talked about last game. I really think it's something where AA, and we saw problems with this last game. The AA wasn't far enough away from the fight to get off those big AA blasts that hit all five of the enemies. And he goes these utility items, which require him to be in the fight, but of course, that really reduces the AoE that you get out of Ice Blast. And so I think I would have preferred him to go the Midas to go straight into Aghanim's, but maybe they're feeling like the fight is being brought too far to them. And now, actually, speaking of Skanks,
Oh,
he's gonna get
hookshot.
caught out. Hookshot comes in. Will there be any fallout? No, just Bane just uses the Brain Sap. He doesn't even need to worry about Fiend's Grip. So
Looked like a
I
smoke into the
don't.
pit for NiP once that they smoke for kill, and now into the pit looks like Roshan is on the list. You talked about it earlier, and without the Ancient Apparition, it gets much, much harder to contest this. I mean, he can buy back, he can throw out the Ice Blast, and then you have the Earthshaker. Maybe next time he recently finished off that Blink Dagger. But it doesn't look like Golden Boys actually want to try and go for this.
I don't think there's anything they can do. AA is down. They can throw a blast at the pit, but it's going to be too late by the time the AA respawns. And yeah, you can't fight into five right now with the state of your heroes, so. Everything
Another
just
big
gotta
advantage,
calm down.
Another
I think that.
advantage though for NiP. They're playing this game very methodically here.
Yeah, with the way the rubber band works, you really don't want to, if you can avoid it, give away anything. They're about 7.5k gold and experience ahead. So not wanting to get those turnaround fights, and Clockwork might get picked off here by Madara. Although there's a lot of support around. They're gonna AA blast. Madara has to go and stop him. Yeah, this is gonna be a very dead Junosuke fan. One more bash, yeah. There he goes. But now has to make sure he gets out. Water Sponge up onto Madara. He's taking a lot of damage. There's a fissure, but it doesn't get anything because of the ice, the snowball. And now Madara going down, finished by the rays. Really unfortunate there that he couldn't escape, but
Yeah.
did overstay his welcome. I don't think he needed to go for the lost.
Yeah.
Actually, A is still level. It's still level one Ice Ball, so he did
Yeah.
have to go for that last
He
bash.
probably had to. It was pretty close though, because Hanskin, that was the longest range Water Sponge I ever seen, I gotta say. With the sprint movement speed, barely not able to actually keep him safe. But yeah, it's unfortunate, but I think if you're Gold Boss, you kinda have to go for these plays and hope you get away with it. Just keep NiP honest as much as you can. Try and keep them away from farms, try and keep them away from the rest of your tier 2s, especially with that Aegis. You know that's gonna be NiP's plan, but with Madara dying there, double damage shooting onto Limp to make things worse, it's gonna be a Glyph Force out. This tier 2 will definitely go down. And yeah,
And
there's
Clock
still
has been
Earthshaker down
off.
here, and Yonasamfan will find him. Not quite get him
He
on the
should be able to
cogs,
blink
but
away.
yeah. Oh, is he?
Oh, he
There's.
actually gets hit by the clock. He should still be able to blink up and over because there is no Aghanims yet onto Clockwork. So not quite sure why maybe next time isn't. Yeah, he's gonna be out fine. The Queen of Pain has been forced into a BKB. It's really unfortunate here just because she's been locked down a few times by the Searing Chains. But there's a lot of stuff here that goes through BKB on NiP. The Fiend's Grip, the Walrus Punch, the Hookshot. So she's gonna stop taking some damage from their lineup. She won't be picked off solo by Ember Spirit, but NiP has more than enough to deal with a BKB on her.
Absolutely, it's kind of a really, really bad item to go for. But yeah, as you said, you have to go for it at this point. But the problem is, where's the damage now coming from? And you do have the slot out with level 3 amplifier damage, which is great, but you can only get it off like one or two heroes at a time during the course of a 4-5-5 team fight. Then you have Nerfshaker, who really relies on being able to get a good Echo Slam off. Might be able to here with Hanskin, just walk straight on top of them. Charge comes in to lock them down further. There's a fissure as well. They're focusing on Hanskin, but the Magnus will keep him alive, kicking nice eye shots here to block Skylark in. That'll be the counter kill, and yeah, it'll be that. Yonasafan looking for something else, but only finds the creeps in the way. But Era, he gets Madara here with the Serum Chains, even though he's Invis. Straight under the Sentry Wall, he will fall after getting the crush off. And it's just so hard for Golden Boys now. Every single thing that they try to do, they just not only find one hero, they find five. High mobility here on
Yeah.
NiP, and they're chasing so aggressively. They find Skanks, he's trying to teleport out, but Nera, he has enough damage here with the extra artillery coming in from backlash. Now three heroes down without buyback, that's a tier 3 at the very least. Maybe next
And this is
time
the
he has a Blink
problem.
Echo Slam, but what's that really going to do all alone?
This is the other problem of Quap not going the Aghanim Scepter, no sort of wave clear. If you have the Ags, you can just use that Sonic Wave to repeatedly get rid of the creeps. The cooldown is about the same with the Ags as the creep spawn, it's a little longer, but you can generally just get rid of the creeps and the heroes. And Skylog now just gonna feed, maybe. There is a nice A blast coming out, but again, not quite far enough. And Jonathan Fan, oh, the Sonic Wave, it does manage to hit Jonathan Fan. The Scream gets him, the immediate BKB, not gonna take the stun from that Snowball, but still gonna reposition them. There's the Walrus Punch, what we're talking about going through. Does she have enough mana for a Scream? Jonathan Fan is so tanky. They pick off the AA in the backline. Skylock going for the Nether Strike, and yeah, he gets someone, but he's probably going to pay with his life on the escape here. They have Searing Chains. They have Sleight of Fist. Skylock slowly going down. And so they got all of that for one.
They use so much to make this happen, though. The Echo Slam was used in the backlines here from the Earthshaker to no avail, really. Arrow and Limb, they're both pretty damn healthy, and yeah, they're looking for more maybe next time. He will survive, I guess. Maybe next time he will survive, that's my bad joke there. Era will fall, but certainly the Aegis, and the melee rex is down, the range rex sure to follow. Skylar comes in with a charge, but now he's being slapped up. Era is still alive and kicking now. Madara now in trouble. He uses a crush, but it doesn't do anything up against Snowball, and it's just the world is falling apart, just like the base for Golden Boys right now. And NiP, they have no fear in the world.
Yeah, they're low on buybacks as well on Golden Boys, so while NiP has rotated out, yeah, the Aegis also just used, but it would have expired anyway. He actually got near perfect timing on the Aegis use there, because if you look at the clock, but either way, it's not looking great for Golden Boys, especially when they don't maybe have the carry to deal with this. And how do you hold your base? Yeah, you've got stuff like Ice Blast, you've got the Queen of Pain, but she didn't go Ags, and AA is level 9.
Yeah, there's so many problems for Golden Boys right now. It comes down to the draft. They drafted a heavily momentum-based lineup, and they haven't been able to find this momentum.
With that Spirit Breaker goes down, there's going to be a hookshot forwards as well, looking like a lot of damage taken, and yeah, no way out, you just can't escape.
Can get to these kills quickly enough. Now they will probably scout on Skanks with that rocket here. You know, Savant with that Aghanim Scepter freshly completed. He has another hookshot. Skanks will dodge it for now, but there's so little that Golden Boys can do, as I said.
No, he might not dodge it, but now they're pinging him. So they thought he was a little bit further forwards. He might go for a blind hookshot. That's what you do sometimes because it's such a low cooldown. There's going to be another Ice Blast coming out, but it's going to hit no one. It's just going to choreograph his position. Jonathan Fan? Oh gosh, he knows now. He does. He gets the hookshot off. Not an Ice Blast you wanted to throw, and Chang's is going down. He's going to slowly fall. And that's what I was talking about before. When you Ice Blast, you have to be careful if you're hiding somewhere like that because it completely gives away your trajectory.
This is where you spam in the chat wheel. I immediately regret my decision.
Yeah.
That wasn't
so unfortunate, but it happens to the best of us. And as you said, you're in a place where the safe plays, it just slowly loses you the game. You can't do the safe things anymore. You've got to try to play crazily. This is the way, if you have a gyrocopter, you go divine, because that's all you can do. So looks like these two mid heroes also might be in a bit of trouble. Aeris, Sleight of Fists? No, doesn't get us the Searing Chains. So.
Problem is, with NiP, the way they're playing so freaking safe that it's really, really hard for Gold Boys to find any sort of opportunity. Wouldn't really surprise me. I mean, at the same time, Limp has an Assault Cuirass, so they can go high ground right now, but it wouldn't surprise me if they just waited for next Roshan. It's only a couple of minutes. No reason for them to actually take any sort of risk, because they have the entire map under their control. Golden Boys, they can't feel safe anywhere on the map, even Madara here. I mean, no one is there right now for NiP, but that can change in a heartbeat.
Yep. And it's something where you really don't have to worry, like, you're not... Even if Golden Boys gets a bunch of gold off of you, they're 20,000 net worth behind, 20,000 experience. Maybe they win a team fight. What slot are going to build that wins them the game? Like, maybe he gets an AC out, okay? That just negates presence of the Dark Lord on Shadow Fiend. It's really rough with the position they're in.
Yep. I'm just trying to figure out a way for them to come back, and apart from a big overextension, I just can't think of it. I mean, hate to hop on about it, but it's just...
It does really feel like they're very far behind. Maybe they should try for a smoke gank. They're already in one. They have another in a minute. So I think, you know, trying for a smoke gank, seeing if you can pick off someone, even if you have to lose two to pick off one, you're going to come out top net worth, on top of the net worth for that, just because of how far behind you are. And especially if you can find the Shadow Fiend, or if you gank two of their supports, you'll probably get 2,000 apiece each, because of how far behind you are. So I think these aggressive ganks, it's all you have left. Push out mid a little, go for a gank, but instead there's going to be a walrus punch up onto Kiza and the hookshot. She isn't able to pop her BKB, she's getting pushed back, and now she's just going to escape. But that's a full BKB charge for escaping, and now looks like Searing Chains. No, Slaughter's getting away with his as well.
Yeah, so, I mean, with that BKB,
off them all.
The right clicks. Oh, well, there's Hawkshot right into the base. Skylark will get locked down by the battery, so that's an easy kill. Now, next one, Liz Fiendscript. On to maybe next time, 2 years down without buyback, and now. Yeah, Lim just saying, alright boys, enough with the play. Let's get to work on this tier 3 tower here in the bottom lane.
And it's gonna be actually a really short Roshan, it's 9 minutes, that's a bit shorter than average, and so they can go back for it after they take this Rax. They know they have people down, and so if they're feeling a bit scared of taking the top Rax, they just get it. But it looks like Ember, Searing Chains on two of them, they just burn down so much, it's just a bloody Searing Chains, and they take so much damage, and there's a second set of Rax down. Golden Boys has to have the teamfight of dreams here if they're to do anything. And they don't have the teamfight of dreams for another 20 seconds because AA Blast is down.
Yep. You need everyone grouped up on Echo Slam. But I don't really see NiP going for that. I mean, they have no reason to group up. They have no reason to even worry about anything. Even Era, even if he dies here. Which he isn't, of course, because he's an Ember Spirit who always has a Remnant out. But they still see him, though. And he's being charged up by Skylark, but... And it might actually finish him off now. Never mind. It's like...
Yeah, it's rough. They're gonna chase him, but all the while, Vershawn is going down. Sonic Wave as well, they get him! That's huge for them. We'll see, that's probably like 3,000 gold. But at the same time, I don't even know if Limp cares that they lost Era. They can wait out his death timer. No, so it was only 2.5. But they can wait out this death timer or... go for their next Aegis. No, look, sorry, next Rax, and Clockwork goes down. I was just surprised by that he got caught out of position as well.
Now the cavalry has arrived. Limp leading a charge seal kit here. What with the blockdown that they need? Look at these right clicks. They just have to run away now, and they are doing so. Skylark here actually doing a lot of damage to Handskin here together with Madara. So now it's getting to a point where it's like, all right, maybe we didn't really think this through. Maybe we should just retreat, wait for everyone to come back alive, and then go for. The last set of Rex.
Yeah, it's really nice. They got lucky there for Golden Boys that it was a classic one by one in by NiP, and they did take perfect advantage of it. The charge away by Spirit Breaker to make sure he's just like, oh, SF is here, I'm gonna leave.
Yeah.
And went and helped lock down. Tusk got bashed there. He couldn't get back into a snowball. I think it also, there was cooldowns issues, and okay. Oh no, that's really unfortunate.
What? he just stood there tanking the creeps.
He may have been a bit deceived, he may have not checked his health properly. That happens. So yeah, but they're showing on Golden Boys that they can still get kills.
Madara. Oh, Fiendscript and Lim just bang, bang, bang away. Just so frustrating. The creeps actually get the kills, so not Lim. That's 2 years down. Slada does have buyback, but there's no Ice Blast. There's an Echo Slam. But they're pushing every single lane down now. Arrow here in mid. Limp and Sealkit in front. Yeah, that should
be that. We will have AA Blast up soon, so if they do get the Echo Slam, Sonic Wave of Dreams, they can do it, but I don't know.
Can they though? There's an Aegis and Shadow Fiend. They can barely kill him once, maybe, with everyone bashing away at him. But I don't really think they can kill him twice. Here goes, so they're gonna have to go for it now. There's a charge through. BKB on Skylark, there's the Echo Slam on 2, Slaala with a follow-up here, Era will fall, same with Tusk, they're gonna buy back immediately and get back into the fight ASAP. Madara here, battling up away against Limp, who still has an Aegis here, just man-modes up against both of them, doesn't give a damn. Yeah, Skylark still charging about though, but now one more right click will do the trick, and there's the GG, well played.
It was actually a really good idea in that team fight to take the fight on the weaker heroes, not the one with the Aegis, but as we pointed out, they just didn't have the stuff to take out Limp. Played very well, he got huge, and 2-0 by NiP.
Yeah, bit of an outdraft, bit of an outplay here for NLB in the early game. It's a lineup that can work for Golden Boys, but as I mentioned before, it needs momentum. You need to find a lot of kills here between the Spirit Break and the Slaughter. You need to snowball off of that, and the moment where Limp got off of that, off of these problems that he had in mid lane, being aggressed upon, the moment that Ember Spirit had his items up off of that pretty much free farm that he had in the bottom lane, it was just, not a whole lot to do for Gold Boys anymore.
Yeah, pretty unfortunate there, but they showed a good fight, you know? I think a lot closer than a lot of people think these teams are. It certainly wasn't the stomp that I think folks expected. So a nice job by Golden Boys, and they're still not out. They have other opportunities, right, to qualify.
Yeah, they do, and I think if I'm not much mistaken, they are in the group. Let me actually check that right now. Yeah, they're in the group with Na'Vi, who have, of course, disbanded. I'm not entirely sure. I don't really have a word from the admins just yet what we will do with that. But I do assume that they will just get disqualified. That means that they will fight up against Four Clovers and Leprechaun for that secondary space to the main stage out of this group B. Don't take my word on that, but I do imagine that is what will happen.
Yeah.
But yeah, ninjas in
So.
pajamas, of course, they're already through here. Rather quick to a victory, not so much here, almost an hour in game one. So they had to make a little bit of a comeback, but level game two, 36 minutes, decent time for them. Yeah, that's about it from us. That's the our only best of three. There are more scheduled, but not for today. I believe the next one is. Actually, entirely sure. The next one is in 2 days, Empire versus F5. And then in 4 days, or 5 days almost, we got Alliance versus Priest. That's next Sunday. So head on over to joindota.com, our D2CL coverage page. And there you will find all the information that you can possibly want. And while you're already browsing the web, head on over to Twitter. Follow my co-caster at LlamaDownUnder. And while you're already at it, you can also follow me at DragonDropDota if you enjoyed our cast. And I know, Llama, you are definitely looking for a lot of for any sort of
Feedback, yeah,
hints
oh
and
no,
feedback.
I'm a newer caster. I usually like, yeah, I'm a newer caster. I've got lots of stuff I know I need to work on. I don't normally do analysis, but I still think we did a fun job. I always have fun casting with you, so I think it was fine together. Certainly always two people can always bring more knowledge, but I would love any feedback on how to get better. So yeah, I love that. So
Yeah, definitely give us that, and yeah, hope you got your rest today. Yeah, that's
yeah.
about it for me. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.